what we're going to do today is a demonstration of how we represent our cultures. God has blessed each and every one of us with such a rich culture, and we want to showcase what God has shown has done for us. So at this time, what we're going to be doing is a cultural presentation. And each year, what we try to do is focus on a specific part of our cultures. And however, this year, we're going to really focus, as you know, on respect. How we show, how we demonstrate respect in each of our cultures. So at this time, I would like to start the presentation. Are we ready? Okay, so we're going to get started with Ghana. Ghana, as you say, your... Ghana, you ready? While we're waiting, I think it's only fitting that I should remind you that once the service is over, don't be in such a rush to head out, don't be in such a rush to run out. We actually have quite a lot of delicacies for you to enjoy. So please, as soon as the service is over, kindly go downstairs, and there are lots of delicacies for you to enjoy from each culture. If I can endorse the choir to give us a song. All right, now you don't want me to chase everybody away from here, so let's try this one and you can help me. Hello, Daddy Ren.
You don't want to go.
Okay, here we go. Praise the Lord. We're going to start with the Foursquare Band.
Jamaica!
And of course, the group is going to win. You go win. And they're doing something, they're mowing their grass, they're
working in the garden, you ever offer a helping hand today. The last one that means we also do not call our elders by their first name. They can be friendly to you, but you cannot call them Joyce, Jay, Lydia, or whatever. You have to use the title. You have to call them Ramadan. The reason we do that is because these elders are not your classmates. They have been there, they've let this life that we are living as a youth and keep them in set away. And once you're doing all these things, once you go to Ghana, believe me, you will flow very well and they will love you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, and you see. Praise the Lord. My name is Sami Bar. I'm here to represent the rich culture of Haiti. And respect and high release of our culture. It is simply honoring our elders in our culture. It is very important. There's a saying that goes like this. It says, Timun, which means that little child respect your elders. So that's very important to us, to honor our elders. You know, wherever we go, you know, in the marketplace, wherever we see them. You know, I remember growing up, you know, I had always had the fear of doing something wrong. Because by the time I got home, the people that knew my parents would discipline me along the way. So that's pretty much how I was brought up. But also, you know, when it comes to, the Haitian culture, greeting is very important. You know, we greet people by kissing them on both sides of the cheek. You know, starting from, the oldest person, to the youngest, person. And also, in a gathering of elders, the youth, or any young child, you have to be careful, how you address them. You know, you can't be eavesdropping when they're talking. You have to give them the space to operate. So that's still part of, our culture. And I think that's something that's very similar to, any other culture here where, for instance, when you see an elderly person, you greet them as grandma, you greet them as papa, or you greet them as uncle, or you greet them as auntie, similar to, the same, African culture, which is the creator of all civilization. So today, we're here to celebrate the rich culture, but I think that there are similarities. In light of doing that, we also need to be mindful that there is also another culture that we're representing, which is the culture of Christ. So we can't let, our ethnic or, those of that culture overtake the new person that we have become in Christ. We need to be mindful of that as well too. And I want to thank the leadership of the church, because if we can all be sitting here today, it's a representation of God's love, but it's also a representation of, pastor's allegiance, to serve Christ and to honor God's love. That's why we're here. So I'm just grateful to be in the midst, and I feel appreciated, I feel loved, and I want you to know that I love all of you without any reservation. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. All right, Diana.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm from Guyana, South America, and our culture is very integrated. We have many people living in our country, and because of that, we have many people. We are very respectful. We greet, when we deal with our elders, they are our heart, the elders and the children. So when we greet our elders, we always address them by their titles. We never address them by their first name. And it takes a community of elders to raise our children. It's not done by just one mother. Most of the times, the children are being raised in an extended family. So the children are being raised by grandmothers. So because of that, the children tend to get, the discipline is not more physical. So the only thing that your grandmother has to do in order to get you straight is just look at you. Once you use those eyes, you get yourself in a corner before you know what's next. If you do something wrong from the market, you better not let that person tell your mother, because you're going to get a whipping from the market. spirit all the way to your home. Because everybody's going to find them. And if you're praying along the way, make sure you don't pray so they see. Because when they see you, they want to beat you for what you did, not the mind of spirit that you've already been doing before. So it's all of that. But in all, we are very great with hosting in our country. We like to hope. We like to present a family atmosphere. So when you come, all of that is a part of respect. Because when you come to somebody's house, they always offer you food. By the time you leave the house, you'll be well fed. So that is all part of respect in our country. The children are not allowed to talk back. You talk back, you get beaten. If adults are gathered, your children are not supposed to be there. They have to leave. That is all part of respect. Again, the children always have to respect their elders.
Praise the Lord. I'm here to represent, we are here to represent our rich culture of Cameroon. I'm here with my sister Karen and my husband, Mr. Simon. So Mr. Simon will tell us, and my sister and myself will ask the coach. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And please don't carry away my sister, because I'm told it's all and me. And it takes time and diligence to make it as part of the culture and what great family from. But Cameroon is a very bonjour, monsieur, bonjour. Je m'appelle Sani, I'm in Cameroon, I'm in another country, c'est ma femme, avec ma soeur. So Cameroon is bilingual, speak English and French. But we have like 250 ethnic groups and languages and cultures. So out of this wide variety of options, we have selected just a few. We are also getting modern. We can have a simple handshake and a cheap embrace, which is for familiar people. It shows respect and love. It goes both sides, and sometimes they actually replace it. Sometimes they even have a pet on the lip if you really care for the person. Not here. But this is among the young people, the older people, all generations. The great handshake and the cheap embrace, and the little pet on the lip they have to every once in a while. We also remember a very traditional founded region, the school of the Northern Public Council of the Grand Silvers, is where I come from, and it's a scoop, a clapping of the hand, and a bear. That is how we respect. We do not prostrate. We do not lie down. We stoop, we clap the hands, and we sit there. And just stand up and speak to you. And it is very, very diligently in all areas. It is a sign of respect. You cannot stand at the same level, at the same height with the person that you are addressing. Remember, this is mostly in the hinterland, in the grassland area, that's the area where we come from. It's an area of quite a few young people. It has very powerful tradition and very rich. Now, remember also that we do not address our people by their first names, and a lot of times not by titles also. But we have traditional appellations that we give to all senior people of respect. We say Bola, we say Ben, we say Kim, what do we say again? We say Grandma, Papa, and all of those appellations. Now, there is a last one because of time that we're going to cut it very short. But there is a greeting of familiarity in celebrations. When we acknowledge each other in joy, we celebrate with a very loud sound and an embrace. It is done this way. And you have to hold the person, lift them up, and say, Abba. If you remember that the celebration is not to its full extent, so we have to show them that you love them, you respect them, and you celebrate them. Amen.
Good afternoon. I'm representing, I'm from Jamaica West Indies. I'm representing Jamaica today. Our respect goes a long, long way. In my country, we have most children that respect their parents and their elderly. They will say, they will state elderly by Mr. or Mrs. or Miss. And the one that have the respect, you have to respect people. If not, if you disrespect growing up and you go home, the parents will bring you back to that person and you have to apologize and respect that person and don't do it anymore. The Bible said, children obey your parents. Not only obey your parents, but you have to also respect your parents and your elderly. Parents, you have to first respect yourself, to gain respect, to earn respect, then teach your children how to respect. God bless
you. Thank you. Uganda.
Praise Jesus. I'm going to try to